I was recently blessed by the Tech Deck Gods with this wooden Tech Deck Performance Series Santa Cruz Complete. I found this at my local Target, and in this video I'm going to unbox it and completely upgrade it into a professional fingerboard. Since the channel is coming up on its 2-year anniversary, I wanted to make this upgrade extra special. So not only am I going to be upgrading all of the parts, I'm also going to be reshaping the deck to make it look a little bit more realistic, doing some artwork on top, and giving it a clear coat to give it some added protection. And once the board is completely set up, I want to gift it away to one of you. If you like this board, make sure to watch through the entire video to find out how. Without any further delay, I'm going to get right into upgrading the board. These Tech Deck Performance Series come with regular Tech Deck trucks that come on the less expensive plastic boards. And they do not come with lock nuts. And as you can see, one of the wheels has already fallen off. It actually had fallen off in the package when I opened it. And I put it back on and did a few tricks and it fell off again. So I'm going to be swapping out to trucks that have some lock nuts, as well as taking off this foam grip. I tried to save this original grip, but I think I'm just going to go ahead and put on some better stuff anyways. I was able to get the grip off in one piece, but I had to pull pretty hard and it seemed like it stretched the grip out. With the foam grip tape off, the first thing I'm going to do is shape the board. I'm going to try and straighten out this side, as well as sand everything down. And I'm also going to round the edges of the board to give it more of a rounded shape rather than the squared edge, as well as sand off lettering on the sides. First, I'm going to sand the side of the board to try and make it straight, as well as get off some of the writing. And once I have the board straight, I'm going to go ahead and use a X-Acto blade. And I'm just shaving off a little bit of the graphic to give it a little bit more rounded edge on the bottom side as well. With the board shaped and sanded, it's already looking a lot better. I like how the rounded edges makes the board look a lot thinner, and it just looks more like a realistic skateboard. Next, I decided to add some artwork to the top graphic to make the board extra special, and I added the sticky frog as well as some flame sticky letters. And I also added Teak Tunings tag, which I'm going to come back and make it a little bit more drippy. But I wanted to do a big shout out to Teak Tuning. They were one of my first fingerboards when I got into fingerboarding more serious. And it was the first fingerboard setup that I did on the channel. And I ended up asking everyone what parts they wanted to see on this board. And a lot of you guys actually said Teak Tuning parts and tagged them over on Instagram. And when I reached out to them just to see if they would be interested in donating any parts, they were happy to donate the parts for this upgrade. So I'm super excited to show off the parts that they sent over. They sent over some of their best parts: urethane wheels, trucks, bushings, which they have some of the best tuning, and out of all their products, that's probably one of my favorite things that they have, as well as some of their prolific grip tape. So huge shout out to them, and thank you once again. And I love that Teak Tuning has some really good products that are at a really budget-friendly price and makes it really easy for a lot of people to get into fingerboarding. So if you are getting into fingerboarding, or if you have been into fingerboarding and you haven't checked out Teak Tuning in a while, definitely go check them out. And if you do end up buying anything over on teaktuning.com, make sure to use the code STICKYFB. It'll give you 10% off your entire order. With the top graphic artwork complete, I'm just going to go ahead and mask off the bottom graphic so I can go ahead and put some clear coat on everything, and it'll have a protective coat. I like to do 2 thin coats of clear coat on these, make sure that it has a nice even coat as well as some good protection. After clear coating a handful of these Tech Deck Performance Series, I've definitely found that I like the satin clear enamel the best, as far as the shine that it has, as well as the fact that it doesn't make the actual paintwork look bumpy as much as the gloss paint tends to do. The grip tape that Teak sent over is their prolific foam grip tape with their Teak logo on it. Kind of reminds me of the Matrix. They also sent over some of their Gen 2 Prodigy trucks with inverted kingpin base plates, as well as pivot cups. And for tuning, some red and yellow swirl Pro Duro bubble bushings in the 61A hardness. And last but definitely not least are some of my favorite wheels from Teak Tuning. It's the new Street Shape wheels. They're a urethane wheel in the Ocean Swirl colorway. They are the 61 durometer option and come with ultra spin bearings. I'm going to get started assembling the board by putting the grip tape on. And for this setup, I wanted to do something a little special with the grip tape design. I wanted to make sure that it would show off the top graphic a little bit. So what I ended up doing is trying a few different designs, and I had everyone vote. And you guys voted on this S design. And it kind of just makes an S if you look at the whole shape of the board. And it also kind of, to me, looks like somewhat of a yin-yang shape, especially with the holes cut out for the screws. With the grip tape on and everything cleaned up, I really like the grip tape gap, and it's kind of cool to see the part of the hidden sticky that kind of peeps through the grip tape. Next, I'm going to add the holes to the grip tape, and I like to use something sharp to poke through and then a screwdriver tip that is a little bit bigger just to ream out the hole and make it nice and round. These Gen 2 base plates look really nice with the inverted kingpin and the molded pivot cup. Installing the base plates, I found that the screws went in super easy compared to the Gen 1 of the Prodigy Pro trucks. And I ended up deciding to paint some of the screw heads to match the color theme of the board. With the base plates put on the board nice and snug, I'm going to take the kingpins out and install the tuning as well as the hangers. I personally like to ride my trucks on the loose to kind of medium but still responsive side. And I found with these trucks, if you just put the bubble bushings on, they're pretty loose. But if you do put one of the washers on the very bottom underneath the last bushing, it gives a really nice soft yet responsive kind of feel to it. I'm already really liking how this setup looks with the bushings that are the red and yellow swirl. It kind of matches the Santa Cruz logo in the middle. I really like that the new Prodigy trucks come in an inverted kingpin option. And I always find that these are a little bit more challenging to install, but they do come with the benefit of having a little bit more clearance for when doing grinds. And the trick that I found that works best is just putting the hanger all the way down with the bottom bushing. And then for the top screw, just back it off, go counterclockwise first, and then screw it all the way in. It should go in pretty easily. If it's difficult to go in at first, it's important to back it off and make sure that it's threaded properly to avoid stripping the threads. And with the truck set up, all that's left to do is install the wheels. If you've seen my other videos, you may already know this, but one of my favorite tips is to preload the nuts into the wheel and then pick up everything all at once, and it should screw in pretty easily. I really like the wave colorway on this setup. I love how these bearings sound when spinning, and these also have a decent amount of free spin time as well. With the board completely set up, all that's left to do is test it out with a few tricks. Kickflip, no problem. Fakie ollie, no problem. Nollie, no problem. Another fakie ollie. This board performs really well, and I really like how it looks. It's probably one of my favorite upgrades that I've done on the channel so far. If you have seen any of the other Tech Deck Performance Series upgrades that I've done on the channel before, Let me know in the comments which one is your favorite. Thank you so much for watching all the way through. If you have made it this far, make sure to add a skateboard emoji to your comment. And if you are interested in getting this board, I can't wait to give it away. Make sure to follow over on Instagram and check out the pinned post. I'll also be doing some more channel updates and other things over on there. So make sure to follow if you'd like to. And thanks so much for watching the video. If you did like this video, make sure to hit the like button as well as subscribe. Turn on notifications for when I post my newest videos. And I want to say a huge thank you to everyone who has supported the channel over the last 2 years. And one last shout out to Teak Tuning for donating the parts to upgrade this setup. And congratulations on your recent 10-year anniversary of being a fingerboard company. I have a few other really cool videos planned for the channel that are coming out soon, so stay tuned. And until next time, peace.